Hello everybody, I'm Arachne and this is Skynet, not really, but I am talking about Journey to Sirius. This game was supposed to be a Terminator tie-in, but Sunsoft lost the license before they could finish the game. They made a bad 1 year only contract and they took 14 months to do this game, so they barely missed it. That's why the story intro in-game has the nuke image from Terminator, but actually talks of something completely different. It's a tale of terrorists from Earth being jealous of space colonies, and so they start to make some damage. Your father was working on one of those colonies, and dies getting caught in all the mess. He manages to leave you a message telling you how to stop this terrorist and their robots, so you take courage and risk your life for it all. That's a pretty hefty deal for a young un, but I guess Japan loves seeing teens getting maimed. What? That sounds disgusting. Also, the story is totally completely stolen from Mobile Suit Gundam, but that's okay. Games always stole stories from other media. It's just that this time I recognize the reference material, I usually really don't. The game is really simple when you get down to it. It's a run and gun shooter side scroller, but the part that's refreshing is the controls, because this is a rare early case of good controls. You can change direction mid-jump, and that alone deserves praise because on NES that was a rarity. You can duck to avoid bullets and immediately get up and jump to great effect. It's pretty gnarly. Also, you can change weapons by pressing start and then select, well, to see the selection of weapons at your disposal. You get them permanently when you defeat the mini-boss before the stage boss. Bosses are pretty interesting, varied, and they all are based on logic. There's a simple way to defeat them. You can figure it out for all of them. It's just up to you to understand. And when I say simple, sometimes it's really easy once you get the gist of the battle. The only problem I have with this game is the overabundance of traps. The jumping is really good, but other than that, running and ducking, you don't have any other movement options. It's not really a major problem until the final stage. It's an auto-scroller, and I don't like them. So, that's a bad combo in itself. But it's a pretty long stage too. And you can end up dead by a trap in a bunch of different times and situations, without knowing really what hit you. That's unfortunate because the enemies and their placement are completely fair, apart from literally one enemy that jump scares you in stage 4, but that's it. Fortunately, the music helps a ton, and they are all fantastic tracks. Even the underrated track for the second stage, I think, fits perfectly for the industrial theme of that particular level. I like especially how the boss theme has faster and slower paced sections. It really gives the sense of a battle in which the victor is uncertain, and the result sways from one side to the other all the time. I enjoyed my time with this game a little less than I thought, but not that much to actually hinder me. I wanted Journey to Sirius to have more levels than the mere 5 we got, and for this reason, and the ones explained before, I'll stop myself at a 8.5 out of 10. Also, the game kinda ends in a hurry, and compared to the cool and elaborate intro we get, it's a bit disappointing. Feel free to discuss this video, the review, and the channel in the comment section below. Hope you have fun on here. If you wanna keep up with what I do, follow me on Twitter at @arachneretro. See ya at the next review. Bye bye!